हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल टेक द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द एनवायरनमेंट। वी ऑलरेडी अंडरस्टूड इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट अबाउट द नेचुरल एनवायरनमेंट, दैट मीन्स सराउंडिंग्स विद द टू कंपोनेंट्स, दैट इज अबायोटिक नॉन लिविंग एंड बायोटिक, दैट इज लिविंग कंपोनेंट्स। हियर इन दिस टॉपिक इंटरेक्शन मीन्स वी कैन से इंटर रिलेशन, ओके, इन सिंपल टर्म वी कैन से इंटर रिलेशन between the living and non-living things. So all the living, that is all the biotic components, are connected with non-living components. Understand how? Just listen this example. Animals use leaves, branches, okay, trees or soil for shelter and other living things for food. So all living being to survive or live, they adapt the environment. This form a complex system that is known as an ecosystem. In simple term, ecosystem means a group of living organism that live in and interact with each other in a specific environment, that may be forest, desert, aquatic. We can see from this picture the types of ecosystem: terrestrial, in that grassland, forest, desert; aquatic, we can see ocean and lakes; and in artificial, man-made, aquarium and crop field. So these are the types of ecosystem. Understand? So biotic factors are all of living organism within an ecosystem. These may be plants, animals, fungi and other living things. Abiotic factor like soil, water, air, etc. are important because they directly affect these living components, how they survive. Understood? So the next, survival is possible if condition remain favorable. This means the condition remain favorable. Favorable means good. Then only the organism can live. That means abiotic and biotic factors work together to create a unique ecosystem. And if the living components getting right temperature, food, shelter, etc., then they can easily survive there. But if it is not available, then the survival is not possible. Human environment. Human environment means it refers to the artificial environment that is created by human. Example, buildings, roads, cities, etc. Human beings have always adapted their surrounding environment and also affected it in many ways. If we see in the past, needs were basic and simple, okay, so environment is not affected that much, but human modified the environment to fit the needs of society. That means human being modified the natural environment around them to benefit themselves. That means, for example, we can take land cleared to grow the, they built factories and power plant, etc. So here human being have influenced the environment in many ways. Overpopulation started and their needs increased and started to fulfill their needs, okay. So because of overpopulation, their needs increased and they started to fulfill. So what they have done, they have cleared the forest to get more land for agriculture and used slash and burn agriculture method. Now what is this method? In this method, the land were cleared and cut and remaining vegetation burned. This will help them to fertilize the crop, and the layer of ash provides nutrient rich land, okay. So apart from that, animals were killed for food and other needs like leather and skin, etc. Here all these activities have an impact of adverse, that means a negative impact on the environment. many species of animals and birds have become extinct due to the deforestation. Now, what is deforestation? It's a clearing. Deforestation means clearing of forest on a large scale. Okay, so as a result, it increased the amount of carbon dioxide in the air, which is the main cause of global warming. Now, what is global warming? It's a rising temperature, or rising the average temperature of Earth's climate system, called global warming. Due to this, changes in rainfall pattern, extreme weather, arrival of season, etc., would affect. Overpopulation, pollution, and deforestation are the main cause of global warming. We already understood in our lesson about the natural environment, the two factors, that is biotic and abiotic components, how they relate to each other or interrelated with each other and form a complex system called ecosystem. Now we should understand how to protect the environment also. Conserving resources means resource conservation is the reduction of amount. We have to reduce the amount of solid waste that are generated. Reduction of overall resource consumption, that is reduction in use of water, energy, and raw material. Pollution prevention is a method for reducing the amount of waste created and released into the environment. And cleaning up pollution means all human must be responsible for cleaning up the pollution problem, because we use the environment for our own needs and personal goals. So we have to take care of it and maintain its cleanliness. Thank you.